President Joe Biden held his first news conference of his administration Thursday and pushed back against suggestions his administration is responsible for a surge of immigrants at the border. AP's Sagar Meghani has more.
The president says it has nothing to do with him being a nice guy and rolling back harsh Trump administration actions.
That's not the reason they're coming.
Blaming it instead on an annual seasonal spike and issues in their home nations. Pushed repeatedly on immigration at his first news conference, the president said his administration's expelling the vast majority of those trying to enter, with a big exception.
The only people we're not going to let sitting there on the other side of the Rio Grande by themselves with no help, our children.
And says the U.S. will move to quickly move hundreds of them out of cramped detention facilities where he says conditions are unacceptable. Sagar Meghani, Washington.
The UN-backed program to ship COVID-19 vaccines worldwide has announced supply delays from an Indian manufacturer in a major setback for the ambitious rollout aimed to help low- and middle-income countries fight the pandemic. Gavi, the Vaccine Alliance, said Thursday that the delays come as India is facing a surge of coronavirus infections that will increase domestic demands on the Serum Institute of India, a pivotal maker behind the COVAX vaccine program. The move will affect up to 40 million doses of the Oxford University AstraZeneca vaccines being manufactured by the Serum Institute that were to be delivered for COVAX this month, as well as 50 million expected next month. The number of Americans seeking unemployment benefits fell sharply last week to 684,000, the fewest since the pandemic erupted a year ago, and a sign that the economy is improving. Final election results show Israel in political deadlock once again, with Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu and his opponents falling short of a governing majority. The Election Commission says, with 100% of the votes counted, that Netanyahu's right-wing Likud party and his natural allies have won 52 seats in the 120-seat Knesset, Israel's parliament. If no one is able to assemble a 61-seat majority in weeks of negotiations, then Israel will go to elections for a fifth time in roughly 2 years. A giant backhoe and a squadron of tugboats are still trying to release a cargo ship that's wedged into the Suez Canal and creating a major traffic jam on one of the world's most crucial trade routes. AP's Karen Chamas reports.
Dredgers, tugboats, and even a backhoe failed to free the gigantic cargo ship Ever Given, which ran aground in the narrow man-made canal. The ships waiting to pass have now reached 150 as losses to global shipping mounted. Even with the aid of high tides, authorities have been unable to push the Panama flag container vessel aside, and they're looking for new ideas to free it. In a sign of the turmoil the blockage has caused, the ship's Japanese owner even offered a written apology. Suez expert Lars Jensen says the ramifications of the blockage are huge.
So the longer this lasts, the higher the risk that we're going to see massive congestion problems in the European ports, say a week to 2 weeks from now.
I'm Karen Chamas.
The death toll from last month's winter storm and blackouts in the state of Texas has almost doubled. AP's Ed Donahue reports.
Earlier this month, the state put the initial number of deaths at 57, warning it could go higher. The Texas Department of State Health Services now says 111 people died, a majority of them from hypothermia. The number could continue to rise. Many homes went without power or drinkable water for days after sub-freezing temperatures, failing power plants, and record demand for heat pushed the electric grid in Texas to the breaking point. More than 4 million customers lost power. The number of dead from the storm exceeded 2017's Hurricane Harvey, which killed 68 people in Texas. I'm Ed Donahue.
The University of Southern California has agreed to an $852 million settlement with more than 700 women who have accused the college's longtime campus gynecologist of sexual abuse. Attorney John Manley announced the settlement on behalf of hundreds of Dr. George Tyndall's victims. Tyndall, who worked at the school for nearly three decades, faces 35 criminal counts of alleged sexual misconduct at the university's Student Health Center.
Hi, thank you for watching. I hope the videos are useful for you. Please subscribe to my channel using the button below.